Hi, I'm Brooke.
Hi, I'm Joe.
And I'm Heather.
And we're the Sweet Magnolias.
Okay, so 2021 yes. is wrapping up.
Yeah.
What are you ladies most excited about in 2022?
Do you have an answer?
I have an answer.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm excited for everyone to see our show.
Yeah.
Season two.
I know. Can you believe it's actually happening?
It's so exciting.
It's good. They're going to be excited.
I know.
They're going to be excited.
Well, I think it would have of course, happened a little earlier, but we had that little mandatory halt.
Yes.
Right. In right, the world. Right. But yeah. So now there's just all this expectation, and people have asked so many times, but I'm excited for them to see it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it'll be a lot of fun.
I'm excited to see it.
Me too.
I know.
Yeah.
I mean, you know what is weird and people don't understand is like all the stuff that you have done that I was not privy to see.
Yeah.
So I'm excited to see what
you guys have done.
Yeah.
All the stuff you're not there for.
That I'm not there for.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
It's gonna be fun.
I'm excited for, this is one of my favorite things about the new year is like the unexpected.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, when you get a phone call and it's like, oh, I didn't know that phone call was coming. Like, there's no way I would have known to ask for that or guess for that or hope for that or, you know what I mean? Like, I get excited for, like, the thing I don't know is coming.
What did
in a good way.
One time, what was the, something about what is divinely yours or something like that?
Whatever's divinely yours cannot be taken away from you.
It's true.
Yeah.
Well, I hope there's a lot of good stuff coming.
Yeah, me too.
Divinely yours.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Be good.
So,
what do you have a New Year's resolution? Do you guys make them?
No, not really. Mm. Well, this year I decided that I was going to do a little ritual where I was going to let go of things because, you know, a lot has happened in the past couple of years, and I think it's time to just say, you know what, I'm going to give myself the grace and kindness just to say, I'm not going to hold on to that anymore. Mm. So I'm letting go of some things.
I love the, like, give yourself some grace.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good thing.
I decided a few years ago that I wasn't going to make resolutions anymore, but do, like, a revolution. Like, just change. Because I think with my resolutions, by the end of January, I'm like,
honey, oh. I'm like, I have failed miserably.
right.
I'm going to have to find a new year. But to just deal with whatever that change is and try to live into it. I want to make sure I'm a better mommy and a better wife and daughter and woman, you know. But I do think that that's a great one because I feel myself kind of shedding as well. And to give myself the grace to do that, just not only shed the emotional stuff, you know what I mean? Like things that you're just like, look, why are we holding on to that? But
and make some space for the unexpected.
Yeah, the unexpected.
Yeah. I think that's a good
nice. Thing. Also, because like the old thinking of what a resolution is implies that you're not already great or wonderful or perfect as you are
doing
with
enough.
All of your wonderful and fallacies, all those things. So like I love the acceptance and kind of the like, let's change. Like, let's let go and let new is, really cool. I'm going to do, this is what mine is, I am going to, and God, I hope I make it past March, but I am going to write down in the little notes section on my phone, you know how they say you learn something new every day?
Yeah.
Well, I've always been like, do you learn something new every day? But you kind of do, and so I'm going to write down what I learn new every day. And then at the end of the year, you'd go, oh my God, look at all I learned.
Will you make a book out of it?
Maybe.
That'd be very cool.
I think that's very cool.
Yeah. So I'm going to do that.
Idea.
The other one I have is to write down the positive things that happened that day because sometimes it's really easy at the end of the year to only remember the things that were hard or that were struggling.
Yes.
And then if you look back, you're like, oh yeah, that person said a nice thing to me and I forgot that I got that parking spot. And I forget, those little things that kind of get forgotten. So those are my two that I'm...
I like that.
On that, building on that, I read something the other day that really was nice because I tell people that I love... Like, when I feel that I love someone, I say I love... And I know it makes people feel uncomfortable because I'll be like, I love you. And people are like, love you too. maybe it's just the woman at the grocery store checkout. And I'm like, I love you. Thank you so much for this lovely little chat.
Thank you.
But I think also just taking time to tell people what you admire about them.
Yes.
Sometimes it's so easy to just not even take someone for granted intentionally, but just stopping and being like, you know, you're really good at that.
Yeah.
Yes.
So
or saying thank you.
Yes.
I know, coming around and just saying thank you.
Like,
I even thought like yesterday we were in the airport and there was the gentleman was cleaning, you know, and I was like, I need to tell him thank you because I feel like it's one of those thankless things that people don't say, you know,
right.
And to just stop him and however he takes it, hey, just thank you for that.
Yeah,
that's nice.
Because But I think to have those moments more, because people do appreciate it. I think you never know that moment that person said, I needed to hear that I love you, that somebody loves me.
And I feel like people are more shocked when it happens because it's so rare.
Yeah.
That and then we don't know how to take nice or love or whatever. Yeah. So, but I do feel like whether they are able to say it in the moment of hey, that meant a lot to me that you said that, they go away.
Yeah.
And feel that way.
It feels
like so.
You feel seen.
Yeah.
All right.
That's a good one.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
I'll check in on your list when I see you.
Yes, right? That's why I was like, dear God, I hope I make it,
I can't wait.
Hope I make it past,
What did you learn today?
What did you learn today? You actually, it's weird, you do kind of learn something new every day.
And I'll be like, you know what? I think I taught her that. Number, you know.
Who taught me this? Maybe I should
write down who taught me. Day 242, that was me, for sure. I definitely taught her that. That was me.
Joanna taught me.
Yeah, I would like just like one little...
I'll give a nod to both of you. Yeah.
All I'm going to try to do is teach you everything now.
I wouldn't learn that.
Right? I'm going to have a bunch of people condescendingly teaching to me all the time. No,
but I would try not to learn a lot of stuff from Joanna because it's not going to be.
It'll be fine.
It'll get you in jail.
It will. It's okay.
It's okay. But she'll tell me she loves me. And then it all works out.
I love that you're willing to go to jail with me.